My brothers and sisters, may the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. One of those at table with Jesus said to him, "Blessed is the one who will dine in the kingdom of God." He replied to him, "A man gave a great dinner to which he invited many. When the time for the dinner came, he dispatched his servant to say to those invited, 'Come, everything is now ready.' But one by one they all began to excuse themselves. The first said to him, 'I have purchased a field and must go to examine it. I ask you, consider me excused.' And another said, 'I have purchased 5 yoke of oxen and am on my way to evaluate them. I ask you to consider me excused.' And another said, 'I have just married a woman, and therefore I cannot come.' The servant went and reported this to his master. And then the master of the house, in a rage, commanded his servant, 'Go out quickly into the streets and alleys of the town, and bring in here the poor and the crippled, the blind and the lame.' The servant reported, 'Sir, your orders have been carried out, and still there is room.' The master then ordered the servant, 'Go out to the highways and hedgerows and make people come in that my home may be filled. For I tell you, none of those men who were invited will taste my dinner.'" The Gospel of the Lord. Yesterday, as you recall, the Gospel focused upon Jesus' having dinner in the home of a leading Pharisee and him suggesting to the Pharisee who was giving the dinner that he should give places of honor to others, not to those who look for them, and that he should invite those individuals who cannot repay back for giving the gift. And the Gospel today picks up essentially right at the end of that particular segment we just heard yesterday, where somebody at the table then says to Jesus, "Blessed is the one who's able to eat in the kingdom of God." And it's, of course, the first indication, if you will, of at least one of these people sensing the reality of what's being suggested here. We're not talking about this meal on the Sabbath in the house of the Pharisee. We're talking about the eternal banquet, the heavenly banquet, and the invitation that God gives to all people to be part of that. Every time we gather at this table, we sort of live that for a moment. We are aware of the fact that this is what we do until that day comes. We hopefully are all, God willingly, sitting at the table in the new kingdom. And every time we gather at this Eucharist, we say just before we receive communion, "Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are those called to the supper of the Lamb." This is the supper of the Lamb, and we take it sometimes for granted. And fortunately, God, in his concern and care and graciousness for us, continues to invite all to be part of it, if they're only willing to accept in turn the responsibility to live it, not just in what they say, but in what they do. Of course, that's what Paul is talking about in their first reading today, as he suggests that every single one of us are in relationship in Christ and help to build up the body of Christ. Each of us have something unique to offer. Whatever that is, that is part and parcel of our gift and talent, is the very thing which we are told in turn to share with those who are around us.